Hello, welcome back to Learn Physics. In today's topic, we are starting a new chapter, that is Mechanical Properties of Solids. Okay, this is for class 11 students. Okay, so in Mechanical Properties of Solids, we are studying about what will happen if we are applying a force to an object. Okay, so that is in the case of solids. Okay, solids means it's a rigid body. We will consider the solid as a rigid body. Okay, in system of particles we consider the rigid body, isn't it? So when we are applying any external force, okay, that object won't be changing its size and shape, isn't it? That is a rigid body. Solids means all the particles are very closely packed, isn't it? In chemistry also you would have learned about this properties of matter, in that three states of matter: solids, liquids and gases. And then next plasma, Bose-Einstein condensation, and next other matter, the other kind of matter is also there, but here we are considering about the solids. Okay, so first we are studying about the elastic property of a solid. What is meant by this elasticity? Elasticity means elastic. Elastic means if I am applying a force to an object. Suppose I have a rubber band in hand and I am applying a force. Then I am releasing it. What will happen? The rubber band will come back to the original position, isn't it? So I am applying a force. Where it had gone, the object is that's accepting that force, isn't it? While the object is accepting that force, that is called as restoring force. In that object, it is restoring. Okay, the applied force is given by us. Okay, and that force is restoring in that object. And what is happening to that force afterwards? See, while we are releasing, that restoring force will be helping it to come back to the original position. That is called a deforming force. It is converting it into deforming. So here you should consider about the three forces: applied force, next is restoring force, and next is deforming force. Deforming means coming back to the original position, original form. That is deforming force. When I am applying some force to an object, what is happening? It is restoring in that object and it is coming to deform, isn't it? It's deforming force. It is converting to deforming force. So what is meant by elasticity? So elasticity is the property of a body by virtue of which it regain its original shape and size after the removal of applied force. If we are removing the applied force, the object will be regaining its original shape and size. Regain original size and shape. Okay, that is called elasticity. Elasticity is the object will be regaining its original size and shape. That property is called as elasticity. So elasticity is the property by virtue of which it regain its original size and shape. So if it is not it's regaining its original size and shape after the removal of the applied force, then we can say it is called a plasticity. So plasticity means won't regain. Okay, won't regain. That is called a plasticity. And elasticity is the object will be coming back to its original state or original position. So if while we are considering a solid will be consisting of large number of particles, isn't it? All the particles are very closely packed. So we can consider that, see, each particle is attached with a spring. Like that we can consider. Okay, so while we are applying some force, then next also this will be continuing in that way. Okay, here in all the sides it will be continuing. So here while we are applying a force, what will happen? So it will be it's compressing, so whether it is compressing or if it is extending, anyway. Okay, so the balls will be coming together and the spring will be coming back, going back to the original position, isn't it? So that is what happening in the case of elasticity. Okay, so in the case of plasticity means it won't be regaining its original size and shape. Say I am taking a glass and breaking it into two, what will happen? I can't, it's very difficult to keep it back in the same shape, isn't it? So that is called a plasticity, and if it is regaining its original shape, then we can say it as elasticity. Okay, so now we are going to study about what is meant by stress and strain. Okay, next is stress. First we are going to study about the stress. Stress means force acting per unit area, that is called as stress. It is the force, perpendicular force acting per unit area is called as force. Force acting per unit area, that is called as stress. So basically what is the meaning of stress? Force acting, how much force is acting in a unit area, that is called a stress. Stress mainly, see, of many types. First we are considering about the longitudinal stress. Longitudinal stress means lengthwise. If the force acting per unit area in lengthwise, if any force is acting, see I am stretching the rubber band, or if I am compressing a solid, okay, what is happening? Length is decreasing, isn't it? So if I am compressing or if I am extending that one, so then it is called a longitudinal stress. Okay, so longitudinal stress, we can divide it into two, compressive stress and tensile stress. Tensile stress means length is increasing. If length is decreasing, then we will say it is compressive. I am taking a spring and I am compressing it. So it is compressive stress. Compressive stress means it is that also coming under longitudinal stress only. Longitudinal, length is increasing means it is tensile stress, and length is decreasing means it will be compressive stress. Okay, clear? So what is the stress? What is meant by stress? And one type of stress we learnt. Next is, it is volume stress. By the application of the force, volume is changing. That is called a volume stress. Okay, then next is tangential stress. Tangential stress we will call otherwise as shearing stress. Shearing stress. Tangential stress means if we are applying any force tangentially, tangential to the object, if we are applying any force, that is called a tangential stress. So here, see, consider this as an object. If I am applying tangentially this force, so it is, see, you can see this side. Okay, here it is, everything is in the same, one behind the other, like that you can see. Now if I am applying a force in this way, what is happening? Only the front portion where I am applying the force, that is moving towards front, isn't it? Back side, it is still in that position only. So here angle wise one slight increment will be happening, isn't it? Down part is at the same position, only the front part is increasing, isn't it? So here when it is increasing in this manner, you can see, right? So here if this is the down part where it is keeping in the same position, only upper part. So we were applying a force tangential to that object, isn't it? Tangentially force is applying, so it is called a tangential stress. Okay, so understood what is stress? Stress is the force acting per unit area, that is longitudinal stress, volume stress and tangential stress. Okay, longitudinal stress itself of two types, compressive stress and tensile stress. Okay, force per unit area. So what will be the unit of the stress? Stress is newton per meter square. Okay, stress is a vector quantity and its unit is Newton per meter square. What will be the dimension? MLT to the power minus 2 divided by L square. So it is ML to the power minus 1 T to the power minus 2. This will be the dimension of stress. Okay. So it's easy, right? Next is strain. So mainly this chapter onwards, not that much to think and all. It's very easy. Only thing is, if you are reading and learning also, you can write down that many number of derivations. Derivations are there, but all are very easy derivations. From gravitation onwards, like that only. It's very easy chapters. While you are reading it, you can understand and understand the concept. That's all. Okay. So next is strain. Strain means, so now we apply the force in different lengthwise we are applying, volume wise we are applying, or tangentially we are applying. So in those cases and all, some changes will be happening to the dimensions, isn't it? So change in dimension to the original dimension, that ratio is called as strain. Okay, so while I'm compressing the object, change is decreasing, isn't it? While I'm if I'm applying a tensile stress, what will happen? Length is increasing. That is longitudinal stress, means either length will increase or decrease. Volume stress means volume will increase or decrease. Tangential strain means that tangentially we are applying a force. So there also some changes are happening to the original dimension, isn't it? So strain is defined as the ratio of change in dimension to the original dimension. Change in dimension to the original dimension, that is called as strain. Okay, strain is ratio of change in dimension to the original dimension. So dimension length, if I am taking, what will happen? Change in length by original length. Volume, if I am taking, change in volume divided by original volume. And if I am taking the tensile stress, shearing stress, that I will tell you how we are calculating the shearing strain. Okay, so here first we are going to, so what will be the unit of strain? It has no unit, because dimension divided by same dimension we will be considering, isn't it? If what is the change happening to a particular dimension divided by that dimension itself, suppose if it is length, centimeter by centimeter, or meter by meter, if it is volume, meter cube divided by meter cube. So it is change in volume divided by original volume, right? So volume, that unit will be cancelling. So there is no unit for the unit for strain, no unit. So dimension also, dimensionless variable. It is a dimensionless variable, because dimension of length by dimension of length, it will cancel. Dimension of volume by dimension of volume, that will also cancel. So dimensionless variable. It's a dimensionless variable. So here first we are going to study about the longitudinal strain. So what is meant by longitudinal strain? Longitudinal strain means change in length divided by original length. Delta L. Delta is the small change which is happening. To represent that one, we are using delta symbol, Greek alphabet delta we are using. Delta L by L. That is the longitudinal stress. Next we are going to study about the volume strain. Not stress, strain, okay? Longitudinal strain. Next is volume strain. What is meant by this volume strain? Change in volume by original volume. Change in volume means delta V divided by original volume is V. Next is tangential strain. How we can find out the tangential strain? See, suppose the object is here. Object is here and I am applying, having length L. Okay, this side also length. I am applying a force in this manner. What is happening? This will be going to this direction, isn't it? This is, if it is B, means delta B, it is increasing. Okay, so that means it is making an angle theta. Okay, correct. So this tan theta angle is called as shearing strain. shearing strain will be the angle, how much it is increased. That increment is known as the tan theta. Theta is the angle of inclination. Tan theta is known as the shearing strain. Okay, delta B by L while we are considering also, we will get it as B plus delta B by original B. Isn't it? That is delta tan theta. Opposite side divided by adjacent side while you are taking also, you will get the same manner. So, understood what is stress? Stress is of three types mainly, longitudinal, volume and tangential. The same way we can write down for the strain also. Strain is the change in dimension to the original dimension. Okay, clear? Next we are going to study about Hooke's law. Hooke's law. So, before studying about this Hooke's law, we should learn about another term called elastic limit. What is meant by this elastic limit? Elastic limit means, see here the property, I am considering an object, that rubber band. I am applying a force and releasing. What will happen? It will come back to the original place. And again I am applying a force, coming back. I am repeating it for many times. What will happen? It will extend its original shape. Isn't it? It won't come back to the original shape. Suppose if this was the original dimension, and after applying the force many times, it will be increasing its length. That means this will be permanently existing for that one. Isn't it? It is not coming, it is going to the plastic region, isn't it? So otherwise if I am applying, so same way, I am taking a spring. So many times while I am doing, at a particular time, it will break also. That is, it will lose its elastic property. Okay, so that is, it is converting to plasticity, isn't it? The maximum value for which that elastic property is existing, that maximum value is called a elastic limit. So afterwards it is losing its elastic property. So that limiting point is called as elastic limit. Okay, so the maximum value in which it is existing, that elastic properties, that value is called as elastic limit. So Hooke's law is telling within the elastic limit, within the elastic limit, stress is directly proportional to strain. Okay, within the elastic limit, stress is directly proportional to strain. That is known as Hooke's law. That is, stress is equal to, this proportionality sign we can remove by multiplying it with a constant, isn't it? Strain. Constant into strain. Or we can write it as stress by strain as a constant. So this is happening only within the elastic limit. Within the elastic limit, stress is directly proportional to strain. Okay, understood how we are writing down? This constant has another name. That one we will be learning it later. Okay, so understood, stress is proportional to strain, stress by strain is a constant, that constant is the name of that constant we will study, that is okay, then now stress by strain is a constant. Okay, so next we are going to study about the stress strain curve. Stress strain curve. So here, this is in y-axis, I am representing the stress. X-axis, I am representing the strain. Stress here, sigma is the representation for stress. Okay. So, we know, see, I am taking one elastic material or rubber band I am considering. I am applying a force. What will happen? It is coming back. When I am leaving that force or removing the force, what will happen? It will come back to the original position. That will continue up to a particular point. That is, within the elastic limit, the stress is directly proportional to strain, isn't it? So, it is, stress is proportional means it will be a straight line like this. Okay, from the origin, it is starting and reaching to the point A. Okay, afterwards it won't be coming back to the original position, isn't it? So it is losing its proportionality. Okay, see here B is here, I am considering the point C here, in this points and all, it won't come back to the original position. Then afterwards, when I am applying a force after that also, what will happen? Yes, it is, say if from C, if I am extending that, what will happen? It will come back to this point O dash, isn't it? This O dash is called as permanent set. Permanent set, that is, after this extension will remain like this, it won't come back to this position, isn't it? So that is called a permanent set. So afterwards, what will happen? While we are applying the force, a small force if I am applying also, it will extend more, isn't it? So that with that also not proportional. For small stress, we will get a very small stress, but the strain is more, like that we will get. Then after a particular point, what will happen? It will, see, it will reach to the point D, and then it will come to the point E. That point, it will be breaking, it will break. So now here E is the fracture point. So here what we will say for this point B, see, B is called as elastic limit. Okay, B is known as the elastic limit, and in that elastic limit, or we can say it as yield point. Okay, B is otherwise called as yield point or elastic limit, and the respective stress is called as yield strength. So stress corresponding to that point is called as yield strength. Yield strength. Then next, this up to the point C, it is coming back O dash, isn't it? Now the point D. At the point D, that is called ultimate stress point or ultimate tensile strength. Okay, ultimate tensile strength. And E is known as fracture point. Fracture point. Okay, so at the O to A, it is perfectly obeying the Hooke's law. Then till B, that elastic property will be remaining. Then after B, the small forces applying itself, strain will be more, isn't it? So here it is called as this and all coming back to O dash, that is called a plastic deformation. Here elastic deformation is not happening. Instead of that, we can say it is losing its elastic property, right? So within after the elastic limit, so we will call it as plastic deformation. Okay, so and if D and E are very close to each other, okay, here if D and E are close to each other, then we can say that object will be brittle. And if D and E are away from each other, then we can say it is ductile. Okay, it is ductile. Brittle means it will break fast. Okay, ductile means it will take time, it won't be breaking it fast, that much fast. Okay, so understood. Here the stress strain curve is very important. Okay, clear? So I am winding up for today. In next video, we will be continuing with the rest of the portions. Okay, so if you like the channel, please don't forget to subscribe. Thank you for watching. Bye.